Welcome back to part two of my AI navigation series using the new AI navigation package in Unity. I'm Reedster with Far Gaming, and in my first video, I showed you how to make the NavMesh agents move to a specific destination. After some suggestions in the comments, I'm now going to show you how to make the agents follow the player instead. If you haven't seen my first video yet, I highly recommend it so you can get a good foundational understanding of how to use the new AI navigation package. I'll add a link to that video in the description, and with that out of the way, let's get started. So if you watched my last video, this is the exact same scene where we left off, except instead of the destination cube down here, I got rid of that, and I've added a player in the scene, and I've attached a player movement script to him that allows me to click around the scene and move them around. I'll drop a link in the description with a copy of that script if you want to see it. But otherwise, we still have both of our two characters that we want to move around the scene and have go to certain points. They each have an AI controller script that'll manage where they're supposed to go. And then they each have a NavMesh agent on them to allow them to traverse our NavMesh surfaces. The tall character, their nav mesh surface that they're attached to is allowed to go over this little bump in the scene, whereas the shorter guy is only allowed to go around the long way. So all we're going to need to do to make it so that these two characters will follow the player on the screen is just update the AI controller script that we've made. So I'll open that up, and as a quick refresher on what's going on in this script, inside the start function, we are just finding a game object in the scene with the tag destination and setting that equal to our destination variable, which is just a game object. And then we are getting the NavMesh agent component off of the character and setting that equal to our agent variable. And then with our agent, we are telling it to set its destination to our destination variable and whatever its position is. So this is going to tell it to move to the position of whatever is set as the destination. So all we need to change here to make it follow the play around is instead of looking for a game object with the tag destination, we just want to look for a game object with the tag player. And then instead of setting the destination only once at the beginning in the start method, we are going to cut this. And then we are going to create a update method and paste it in there. So now once per frame, the script is going to update the destination that the agent is heading to, depending on where the player is currently at for that frame. So now you're continuously updating as the player is moving around, whatever, you're continuously updating where these agents need to be going. And so that's going to work the way that we want it to. So I can now save this script and go back to my game. I'll increase the size of this down here at the bottom. So now if I hit play, you'll see both of my characters will follow the player around the scene. And as long as the player goes somewhere that these characters are also allowed to go, then they will follow the player there. So that works the way we want it to. That's all for this quick tutorial. If you're not already following me, then hit that subscribe button and drop some suggestions in the comments if there's something specific you'd like me to go over in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.